Now we will discuss the balancing of redox reaction by oxidation number method. Balancing of redox reaction by oxidation number method. Now we can take example Cr2O7 2 minus plus Fe 2 plus convert into Cr3 plus plus Fe 3 plus plus H2. Now step firstly we write the oxidation number on each atom. Firstly we write the equation Cr3 plus plus Fe3 plus plus H2O. Firstly we find out the oxidation number of chromium in dichromate ion, that is a dichromate ion, so that we consider the oxidation number of chromium is equal to X. Here 2 atom of chromium present, so we can multiply it by 2. Plus oxidation number of oxygen is equal to minus 2 as we know, and we can multiply it by 7 because here 7 atom of oxygen present, and it will be equal to minus 2, that is a total charge present on dichromate ion. Now we can solve the equation and it will be minus 14 and is equal to minus 2. 2x is equal to minus 2 plus 14, 2x is equal to plus 12, or x is equal to plus 12 divided by 2, this will be plus 6. So we can say that oxidation number of chromium is equal to plus 6 in dichromate ion. As we know, oxidation number of oxygen is equal to minus 2. Here oxidation number of iron is equal to plus 2 because plus 2 charge present on ferrous ion. And here oxidation number of chromium is equal to plus 3 because plus 3 charge present on chromium ion. Here oxidation number of iron is equal to plus 3 because plus 3 charge present on iron ion. As we know, in water molecule oxidation number of iron is equal to plus 1 and oxidation number of oxygen is equal to minus 2. Now step second, we have to identify the atoms which undergoing the change in oxidation number. Now step second. Firstly we write the equation Cr2O7 2 minus plus Fe 2 plus convert into Cr3 plus plus Fe 3 plus plus S. Before reaction oxidation number of chromium is equal to plus 6 and after reaction it is plus 3. So we can say that there is a decrease in oxidation number of chromium by 3. So oxidation number decreased by 3. For iron, before reaction oxidation number is equal to plus 2 and after reaction oxidation number is equal to plus 3. So we can say that oxidation number increased by 1. But in chromate ion there is 2 chromium atom present, so we can say that for 1 chromium atom there is a decreased is equal to plus 3, but for 2 chromium atom it will be equal to 6. So we can say that for 2 chromium atom we can multiply 3 by 2, so it will be is equal to 6. So we can say that for 1 chromate ion there is a decrease of 6 in oxidation number, and here only 1 iron atom present, so we can say that oxidation number increased by 1. Now step third, equalize the decrease in oxidation number. So according to equation Cr2O7 2 minus plus Fe 2 plus convert into Cr3 plus plus Fe 3 plus plus S2, because here as we discussed before increase of 6 in oxidation, decrease of 6 in oxidation number, here only increase of 1 in oxidation number, so we can multiply by 6 in order to equalize the increase and decrease in oxidation number. So we can write 6 for Fe2 plus. Now we can say that decrease and increase in oxidation number has been balanced. Now step 4, balancing the other atoms except hydrogen and oxygen. Step, according to this step, we have to balance the atoms other than oxygen and hydrogen. So equation is Cr2O7 2- + 6 Fe2+, convert into Cr3+ + Fe3+ + S2. So firstly we have two balanced chromium atom. Here two chromium atom present, so we can write 2 before Cr3+ in order to balance chromium atom. Here 6 iron atom present, so we can write 6 before Fe3+ in order to balance Fe atom. So now chromium and iron have been balanced. Now step 5, balancing of oxygen. Reaction is Cr2O7 2- + 6 Fe2+, convert into 2 Cr3+ + 6 Fe3+ + S2. Here 7 oxygen atom present, but here only 1 oxygen atom present. So we can add 6 H2O in order to balance oxygen atom. Now here 1 + 6 = 7 oxygen atom present. Here also 6 oxygen atom present. So we can say that oxygen has been balanced. Now step 6, balancing of hydrogen. And we can balance hydrogen by H+ ions. Firstly we write the above equation. Cr2O7 2- + 6 Fe2+, convert into C2Cr3+ + 6 Fe3+ + 6 + 1 = 7 S2. Here 7 × 2 = 14 hydrogen atom present. Here 0 hydrogen atom present, so we can write 14 H+ here in order to balance hydrogen atoms. Now here 14 hydrogen atom, here also 14 hydrogen atom, so we can say that hydrogen has been balanced. Now step 7, we can say that this redox reaction has been balanced. We can check it. Here 2 chromium atom present, here also 2 chromium atom present. Here 6 iron atom present, here also 6 iron atom. Here 14 hydrogen atom present, here also 7 × 2 = 14 hydrogen atom. Here 7 oxygen atom present, here also 7 × 1 = 7 oxygen atom. Now we can check charge in both sides. Here -2 charge on chromate ion plus 2 charge on each ferrous ion. So we can say that for 6 it will be 6 × +2 plus here +1 charge on each hydrogen ion. So we can say that 14 + 14 charge will be present on 14 hydrogen ion. So it will be equal to -2 + 12 + 14 and is equal to 24 + 24. Now we can check in right hand side. Here 3+ charge on chromium ion, here 2 chromium ion present, so we can write 2 × +3 + here +3 charge on each iron atom. So here 6 iron atom present, so we can write 6 × +3 + S2 is a neutral molecule, so we can write 7 × 0, 7 S2 molecule and 0 for each water molecule, so we can write 7 × 0 and it will be +6 + 18 = +24. So we can say that there is +24 charge in both sides, so we can say that reaction has been balanced.